Hi again, and welcome to the final part of this three-part series on how to set up and use the MMBT-S from NEUROSPEC. Today, we'll be looking at using the MMBT-S together with the DSI, a revolutionary dry EEG system from Wearable Sensing, and E-Prime from Psychology Software Tools. Before we start, it is worth mentioning that this setup essentially is the same across all the EEG systems out there. In previous episodes, we looked at installing drivers, sending triggers with our trigger testing tool called Tachyon, and also the setup with presentation software and the Active 2 from Biosemi. I'll be linking those videos in the description below. If you haven't yet installed the drivers, definitely check part 1 before watching this video. So here in front of me, we have the MMBT-S, and to my left, the DSI-7 from Wearable Sensing. The DSI's trigger input port is located on the back of the top part of the DSI. There are two different ways we can send triggers to the DSI, either in a wired or wireless fashion. We'll be showing you both in today's video. I'll also be showing you how to set up two computers. So we have a stimulus presentation computer running E-Prime, as well as a data acquisition computer recording the entire data. On this stimulation computer, we have E-Prime from Psychology Software Tools installed and running, which you can also find over at our shop, shop.neurospec.com. Link in the description below. During an experiment, you want to ensure all events are precisely logged in and together with your EEG data. This is where E-Prime comes in. Every time a stimulus gets presented, we send a trigger marker. This trigger marker will then be captured by our EEG system or any other biosignal amplifier we have connected. Triggers are sent from E-Prime via the USB port of the computer to the MMBT-S. The MMBT-S then forwards that exact same trigger via the D-sub-25 output port to the trigger input port of the DSI. As explained in part 1, the MMBT-S is currently the fastest system available on the market with a delay in the sub-millisecond area compared to a legacy LPT port. Over on our data acquisition computer, we have DSI Streamer running. DSI Streamer will record the EEG data and triggers during our experiment. For this particular setup, we have the MMBT-S set to simple mode. The DSI requires a trigger pulse width of 20 milliseconds. As in pulse mode, the trigger pulse width is 8 milliseconds, we need to change the runtime mode to simple mode. As a reminder, in simple mode, we need to explicitly set the trigger pulse high and then back low again, or else the trigger lines stay high all the time. Before we open E-Prime, we first need to determine the COM port of the MMBT-S. If at this point in time you haven't installed the drivers yet, head on over to the first video and follow the installation guide. Here, I'm showing you how to determine the COM port on a Windows machine. For Linux and macOS operating systems, please refer to the manual, which is linked in the description below, but also supplied with our MMBT-S. First, connect your MMBT-S via the USB cable to your computer. Then, right-click on the Windows Start button and open Device Manager. Next, open the Ports COM and LPT section and take note of the COM port number. Now that we've determined the appropriate COM port number, we're ready to connect the MMBT-S with the DSI. This can be accomplished in either a wired or wireless fashion. For a wired setup, take your DSI trigger cable and connect the D-sub-25 connector to the MMBT-S and the other side of the cable to the trigger input port on the back of the DSI-7. In case you have a DSI-24, the trigger input port is at the exact same location. For a wireless setup, we'll be using the wireless trigger hub. The wireless trigger hub is jam-packed with features, which I won't be explaining in detail today. If you're interested though in a dedicated video on the wireless trigger hub, definitely let me know in the comment section below. The wireless trigger hub has an input and an output side. First, we need to connect the wireless trigger hub to mains power. Next, connect the supply D-sub-25 to D-sub-25 trigger cable to the MMBT-S, as well as the input side of the wireless trigger hub. All signals that are sent to the input side are registered as triggers and sent wireless to the DSI. For the DSI to connect wireless to the wireless trigger hub, we need to plug in the provided receiver dongle into the trigger input on the DSI. Now that we have everything ready, head on over to your stimulus presentation computer and launch E'. In E', navigate to Edit, Experiment. In this settings window, click on the Devices tab and click on Add to add a new device. Select Serial from the available devices list and click on OK. Back in the Devices tab, select the newly added serial device and click Edit. This will bring up a settings window. In the Port Settings window, select from the COM port dropdown the appropriate COM port number and set bits per second to 9600, data bits to 8, parity to none, and stop bits to 1. Then close the Port Settings window by clicking OK. We're almost there. The only thing left to do is to create an experiment and send triggers at given events. For this, I've prepared a sample experiment here in E', which I'll link in the description below and which you can use for your experiments. There are essentially three different ways to send triggers in E'. Either via a task event, inline script, or user script. To keep things simple, I'll be showing you how to use task events to send triggers. Let me know in the comments below if you'd like us to show you how to send triggers using scripts in E'. The experiment I've prepared is very simple. It consists of two text display objects allowing the user to send triggers upon a mouse click. Let's check that out. As you can see, I've already added two text display objects here to the session procedure, starting with a welcome text and another with instructions how to send triggers and end the experiment. Let's open the settings of the second text display object. Under the Task Events tab, we can tell E' when to send a trigger and which trigger to send. I've added two mouse event listeners. The first sends the trigger code 1 when the user's mouse is clicked. The second event looks for the exact same mouse click, but waits for 20 milliseconds, then sends a trigger code 0. As you remember, the DSI requires a trigger pulse width of 20 milliseconds. Since we have the MMBT-S set to simple mode, we need to pull all lines low again after 20 milliseconds. This is done by sending a 0 after 20 milliseconds. We can now start sending triggers to the DSI. Let's test it out. On the data acquisition computer, start the DSI streamer and connect your DSI. In the DSI streamer, when setting the port settings, make sure to select the appropriate mode under trigger source to ensure that the triggers are identified appropriately. Once the data is displayed in DSI streamer, we're ready to start the experiment. In E', hit the Run Experiment button. On the second display event, every time the mouse button is pressed, E' sends a trigger marker to the DSI via the MMBT-S. If the number is odd, then the LED on the MMBT-S will also light up. Heading back to the DSI streamer, we can now see the trigger codes nicely being registered by the DSI. We can see the trigger as a change in signal on the trigger line and as an 8-bit value on the far bottom left. And that rounds it up. We hope you liked this 3-part series on how to set up and use the MMBT-S. If it did, leave a like, and subscribe to our channel to stay tuned for future videos. See you next time!